This is my first day in the hospital with COVID.
It has been almost a month since Jilleen Oar made this video. The 24-year-old is from Slave Lake in northern Alberta. And for the last 24 days, she's been on a ventilator in an Edmonton ICU.
It's hard to see my sister like this because I'm so used to her talking to me and laughing with me. And now it's just, I hear the ventilator just going and going and going. That's all I hear.
Shakira says both she and her big sister were hesitant about the COVID vaccine at first, but they eventually decided it was the right thing to do. Shakira was vaccinated in early August. Jilleen had an appointment near the end of the month. She got sick just 2 days before.
She has or had a blood clot in her lung, so it's severe damage in her right now. And the doctor said that it would most likely take a miracle for her to recover.
ICUs across Alberta are now filled with patients like Jilleen. With lower vaccine coverage, areas of central and northern Alberta have been particularly hard hit.
Our ICU has been just overwhelmed for weeks now, right? Running way beyond maximum capacity. And there's a lot of challenges that go along with that.
It's why last month the province asked Ottawa for help. In addition to a small team of critical care nurses from the Canadian Armed Forces, medical staff from the Canadian Red Cross and the province of Newfoundland are expected to arrive later this week.
I think the help, if it can alleviate or give some reprieve to some of our frontline teams, I think people would be are grateful for that. I worry it won't be enough.
Doctors' groups have been calling on the province to implement more health restrictions, including a lockdown to bring COVID infection numbers down. Scheduled surgeries have now been cancelled across the province for several weeks. Already, there are thousands of surgeries to catch up on. Shakira Oar just hopes her sister will survive.
A lot of people love her, and I know that a lot of people are praying for her.
Heather Yourex-West, Global News, Calgary.